Hi, fifth grade. This is Mrs. Phelps here. We are so pumped and excited about your first day of fifth grade. Because today is a home day, we thought we would use today to go ahead and help set up some of your binders. So this is what this video is. You might be in Ms. Hanks' class or Ms. Sherwood's class or Ms. Phelps' class. We do a lot of team teaching and team planning. So throughout the year, you may see videos from me, you might see videos from Mrs. Hanks, or you might see videos from Mrs. Sherwood, who is the Monday, Wednesday fifth grade teacher. So we're just really excited. We do so much fun things in fifth grade, and we are just pumped to welcome you to the year. So with that being said, let's go ahead and set up our binder. You ready? Okay, here we go. So you should have a binder. Go ahead and get that out. We are not as particular about what things you should have in your binder, in terms of the type of binder for fifth grade. We want you to feel as organized as possible. We want you to feel ready. We want you to be able to access and have all the things that you want. So you could have just a plain plastic binder. You could reuse the binder that you had in fourth grade. You could have a separate one. Whatever you feel like will help you keep the most organized, that's what we want you to have. If that makes sense. Just make sure your name's on it. That's our only requirement. Okay, so when you open it up, part of your supply pack asked for two zippered pouches. So go ahead and put those in your binder first thing. In your first zippered pouch, this is what we're gonna call kind of like your supply pouch, okay? So what you would typically use within a class, this is what will go in here. So you should have Sharpies, you should have 5 or 6 pencils. We know your supply list called for more than that for some of these. And so you're welcome to leave the extras at home and just replenish your supply pack as you go. We 2 glue sticks, a highlighter, a pencil sharpener. What we mean by that is just one of these little handheld doodads so that you can, if your pencil breaks right in the middle of something, you don't have to stop and get up and use our electric pencil sharpener. Just you can grab it out and sharpen your own pencil. Colored pencils, some dry erase markers, and either a dry eraser, like one of these. I ended up finding these on Amazon, just a little handheld one that you can use to erase. You can also use a sock. Just know that, oftentimes if you're using a dry erase sock, they get very dirty. So just make sure to launder them often. And then if your name isn't on it and we find a literal black sock on the floor, it's probably going to go in the trash can. So just keep up with it or make sure your name is on it somehow. And then scissors. So very typical of what you would typically use in a supply pouch. So those are what we have. As we go through this video, I'm going to ask you if you want to go ahead and just set it up along with me. Just go ahead and pause the video, put in the things that you need, and go from there, and then you can unpause the video and move on. Last thing I will say, you do not have to individually write your names on all of these things. We will not require it. You're in fifth grade. We hope at this point you are responsible enough for hanging on to your own supplies. We'll talk about our class cash system tomorrow, actually, when we see you. However, just know that if you are not prepared for class and you have to rent a school supply from us, like a pencil or a glue stick, we charge you money for it. If you drop a pencil at the end of the day and it says Bryn on it, chances are someone is going to see it and go, oh, here's your pencil, Bryn, versus if it's just a pencil that has no name, it gets, we take it and we add it to our supply if you need to rent it. So just a thought on that. You don't have to if you are pretty careful with your supplies. If you're worried or nervous about that, I would suggest labeling them with either your name or your number. Okay, so that's what goes in the first supply pouch. In our second pouch, this is kind of our extra pouch that we keep additional supplies in, okay? So in this pouch, you will keep your binder. If you've read ahead to the history lessons, you know this is, or I mean, excuse me, the reading lessons for today, you know this is our first novel we're starting with, and I asked you to pull it out of your crate and stick it in your pouch. This is what we're talking about, just right like this. If you're in my class, you also came home with your wallet that you'll kind of hold your class cash in. So that will also go in your binder pouch. And then also, your school supply list called for a calculator. I'm not sure if Mrs. Hyland will ask you to use that this year in class or just at home, but go ahead and bring it for the first day just so that you have it. So that is what's in your second supply or your second zippered pouch. Behind that, if you're in my class, you came home with 2 things. One is this, which is your accounting sheet. So as we talk about it, in tomorrow. We'll learn about it, but this is for you to keep track of how much money you have to use on certain items. So just go ahead and clip that in. And then also you have a page protected sheet that has our schedule on the front side of it for you to reference at any point so you know where and when we are. And then on the back, it has an introduction to our class cash system. So if you wanna go ahead and read that, get you excited. We'll talk more about it tomorrow, but that way you kind of have a general thought. So clip that in as well so that you can refer to that throughout the year. After that, you will go ahead and have your binders, your little dividers. We ask for ones that have pockets because sometimes if we're working on something and we're not quite finished with it, we'll ask you to maybe put the worksheet in here and we'll come back to it on Friday or something. So it's just easier than making sure that things stay, get loose and get lost because we know that that's how that happens. These are the 7 divider tabs that we want you to label. And again, feel free to pause the video and label them and then come back to them. But we will reference these throughout the year. So once your dividers are labeled, you should have also had some packets that came home in your crate. So we want you to go ahead and pull those out because we're gonna go ahead and put those in as we go. Okay, so the first one we're gonna have you do is we're gonna find your Behind Rebel Lines packet. You are gonna end up putting that one in reading. And then our school supply list also actually called for some notebook paper. So we want you to just kind of take that notebook paper and divide it into just generally maybe like 4 or 5 little chunks. And so you'll put this one in reading and then a little chunk of the notebook paper so that each divider has a little bit of notebook paper. We don't typically use notebook paper, but there are some times that we have it. So we want you to have just a little bit in it. Don't forget to write your name on it, but you would just clip that in right behind the divider so it's in there. In 5th grade, our packets stay in the binder and we don't pull them out until they're ready to be kind of turned in. So just so you know. So this one goes in reading. You will find the one labeled Author's Purpose, and you're gonna clip that in your writing section, also again with a little bit of notebook paper. You are going to find your Cowboys and New Century. You're gonna clip that one in your history, again with a little bit of notebook paper. Don't forget your name. And then you're gonna find the Scientific Method. That one gets clipped in science. I'm sure you figure that out with some notebook paper and also your name. So make sure that those are all in there with your name on them. That way you don't have to worry about it later. Just a couple of odds and ends as well before we finish up. You also should have a composition notebook that was on your list. That one you will label, it's for Bible. And you will just bring that with you separately from your binder into class. So you can go ahead and stick your name and number or name and Bible on that one. Just make sure you come with it. Same thing, it called for a pack of Play-Doh. If you will just write your name on it somewhere in Sharpie. This is used in Spanish and we just store them in the classroom for you. But then that way if your name is on it, we can readily make sure yours gets to you. Couple of things that are on our supply list that for now you don't need to bring with you to school. So you do not need to bring any replacement supplies. So for example, your supply list called for 36 pencils. You do not need to bring all 36 with you. It's just, we do a lot of writing throughout the year. And so just making sure that you have pencils to replenish. Same with the cap erasers. If you wanna stick a couple in your school supply pouch, you're welcome to, but those are just for when the erasers are out, then you have those to prep for it. The index cards you don't need right away. We do a World War II research project starting in January, so you don't need to do anything with that because you won't need it until January. And then the folder and the earbuds, those are for computer, and we take that second semester. So these 3 items you won't need until January. I'll go ahead and show you kind of the setup of a sample computer folder if you want to just do it now and just have it. This one is, I went ahead and set up Brin's. I ended up getting an extra little pencil pouch to just clip in this part. And in it, I kept her earbuds and a pencil. And then anything else for computer would just be kind of clipped in after that. So that's a thought if that is helpful for you. And then the last thing is, these are the things that you should bring with you on your first day in your backpack. So your binder that you've just lovingly, wonderfully set up is great. Same thing with the Play-Doh, just so that you can drop that in the classroom and not have to worry about it throughout the year. Anything you need for math. So if she's starting with math journals or a book, make sure you have that. Make sure you have your non-messy snack. And a water bottle. Please label the water bottle with your name. The snack you can send separate or in the lunchbox, it doesn't matter. In the mornings, part of our routine is they will make sure that their snack is at their desk for them to use. A lunch, and make sure you come with a smile. We are so excited, cannot wait to see you guys tomorrow. Have a wonderful day.